The AMIC EQ 200 by Brainworks and Plugin Alliance is a mastering grade EQ. This video is a review and a walkthrough of the plugin, and stick until the end. I have a nice little trick for mastering using the AMIC EQ 200. I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Please subscribe to the channel, a channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. Let's get right to it. Here's the plugin. As you can see, the interface is nice and clear laid out with a distinct left and right channel. It's rescalable, so no complaints here. Okay, the knobs, buttons and dials. The bottom first. On the bottom you find Brainworks or Plugin Alliance goodies like switchable mid-side and stereo processing, a mono maker which renders the low end to mono via this rotating knob, and a stereo width dial to make the stereo image wider and smaller. This is something you can also find on the excellent Brainworks BX-XL version 2 limiter plugin. And they have included very nicely a stereo correlation meter to check if you're not going too wide. That emphasizes the mastering functionality of this plugin. It has the Brainworks trademarked TMT, so different snapshots of a channel with very small changes on each channel, which will lead to a bigger sound if you use it on multiple channels. Check out my review of the Brainworks SSL 9000J plugin here to find out more on how TMT works. Here is the THD or Total Harmonic Distortion dial if you want to saturate the channel more. On the sides you find the always useful input gain and output gain dials. And on top you also find a solo mid, a solo sides and the V gain. The parameter link links the left and right side. So when it's on, it links the controls of both channels. All controls are also fully automatable. Let's go over all of the controls of the EQ and of course the sound. The AMAC EQ 200 plugin is inspired by the sound of Brainworks founder Dirk Ulrich's own GML 8200 EQ and vintage Soundtech EQs. And these types of EQs are described as transparent EQs with huge headroom who have surgical precision. The EQ has 5 bands which are subdivided quite interestingly. 2 low bands, 1 mid band and 2 high bands, and these bands have quite an overlap. That adds to the versatility. The lowest bands go from 15 Hz to 780 Hz. The mid band goes from 120 Hz to 7.8 kHz. And the high bands go from 370 Hz to 26 kHz. The buttons have a clear bell-shaped graphic added to it for clarity, and the lowest band and the highest band have an additional selectable shelf. The gain goes by default from minus 15 decibels to plus 15 decibels, and you can switch it to 7 decibels if you want that. This reminds me of the Plugin Alliance Millennia NS EQ. There are switchable low pass and high pass filters for each channel. And in the middle you find the gain scale knob, which will increase or decrease the range of every gain knob at once. And you have invert knob, which immediately inverts all gain knob settings. And now for a real world test. I will use it on this unmastered loop and tweak it a bit and go through more of its settings. First I will use it in mid-side mode and I will enable auto listen. This knob will automatically monitor the Q and EQ settings you set. So let's start with a bit of low end boost on the mid channel, which is the left side. I want to boost around 60 Hz. Let's unlink the channels. Now I want some more snap out of the snare drum. And let's add some mids for the guitars on the side. And now let's link the channels and add some air. And we'll switch it to shelf. And now we'll add some lower mid range on only the mid channel. Okay, let's do a before and after. This is before. This is after. Okay, let's compensate with the output gain. I can make this unmastered loop bigger, fuller, and more punchier without even using compression, just this AMIC 200 EQ. Let's go more in depth and do a non-scientific EQ sound test. I will use this synth pad with some white noise. And I'll repeat this sound quite a bit. If that's too boring for you, go to this timecode for my quick and easy mastering EQ trick with the AMIC EQ 200. For comparison, let's use the standard Cubase frequency EQ, the FabFilter Pro-Q 3 and the AMIC EQ 200. The AMAC is a modeled EQ, analog sounding, and the other two are not. So there will be a difference, and it will be interesting to see how different the sound will be. For this first test, I have set all three EQs to 1 kHz with a Q of 1 and 6 dB of boost. Let's start with the Cubase frequency plugin. And here's the FabFilter. And here's the AMAC. I'll switch around them. You can definitely hear differences here. The AMAC is, let's say, the most musical of the three, or most analog sounding. I'll now repeat the test again, but at 260 Hz with 6 dB of boost and a Q of 1. 260 Hz is around the fundamental note of this synth pad. Let's do it. Again, the same conclusion. They are different and the AMAC is most analog sounding and forgiving. And let's do the test one more time, but this time all plugins are set to 3.5 kHz, again with 6 dB of boost and a Q of 1. Let's start with the Pro-Q 3. And again, same result, but now it almost sounds like the frequency plugin and the Pro-Q 3 are a bit more notched or have a smaller Q. So let me adjust the AMIC EQ and see what happens. Now it got closer, but I had to boost it more and make a smaller cue, but it stayed musical. Okay, I will show you now the little mastering EQ trick with the AMAC 200. First, let me reset the plugin, and I will use the synthesizer pad again. Let's set the plugin on auto listen and find a few resonant frequencies. I will make the EQ small and sweep around the spectrum. Hz for this band. Let's boost it a bit. Let's find another one. Let's boost this one. So I have a resonance around 286 and around 709 Hz, and I will play it and I will press the invert button. So now you have removed a few resonances. This is one way to find resonances in masters by making the EQ small, boost it a bit and sweep around the spectrum and then dip it. The AMAC EQ 200 sounds good and sounds analog. It's quite forgiving and easy to use. I think it's a great sounding EQ for mastering and will find its way on mixes too as a finalizing EQ on individual tracks. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and I'll see you next time. Bye!